Should the coalition agreement be made public?
Well, I can understand why Bill Shorten wants to play these little political games. I mean, we're in the business of beating the Labor Party, and it's not our job to tell Bill Shorten how we're going to do it. We have a principled agreement, a broad principles in that agreement. I've never actually read the agreement myself. It's not something that's made available to individual members of Parliament.
So you don't even know what's in the coalition agreement?
What it does, it sets out the broad principles of how we're going to provide the stability, the certainty and the confidence that Australia needs in its government. Now, that's, the coalition government has served Australia well in many incarnations over many years through different leadership teams. It's never been made public before, and I can understand why Bill would like to see a copy of it, because it probably would help him to beat us next time, but we've got no intention of giving Bill Shorten any help at all.
I'm just a bit surprised that you haven't even seen the coalition agreement.
Well, what you'll see in terms of the most public demonstration of the agreement is at the Governor-General's residence in a week or 10 days' time, when you'll see the swearing-in of government ministers. It'll be the most public example of all of the negotiations, because you'll know which portfolios have been negotiated between the Deputy Prime Minister and the Prime Minister. So to pretend it's some great secret, I think, is a bit
mischievous. But it does divide. It has made a couple of pretty major changes, according to the word of Warren Truss and Barnaby Joyce back in September when it was renegotiated. Water policy went over to the Nats. The effects test was guaranteed to be changed in competition policy. Reduced mobile phone black spots. Some big changes are made in that coalition agreement. And you don't even know what they are, and we don't deserve to know.
Well, it's not a question of what people deserve to know or whether I know or don't know, Matt, to be fair. What I'm saying is it sets out the broad principles of how the coalition operates, and people understand those broad principles in the sense that there's no three-corner contest unless there's an agreement to have that contest, so we don't compete against each other and waste our resources. The ministerial split and the proportions of that are well understood depending on how many seats you win on each party. Now, in terms of the way you've described those other issues, I don't believe there's going to be a long shopping list of other issues attached to it by any stretch. I mean, it's about how the Prime Minister and the Deputy Prime Minister will work together to provide the stability our country needs. And I think it's only reasonable to have a confidential agreement between the two individuals involved.